If you watched the last 562 video, you knew that I was contemplating ordering this filter kit. You see the part numbers there and the barcode for it. This is the upgrade for the older 562s. So, looking at that, if you're tearing your saw down, you're wondering about how all this goes together. Primer line goes to this. The other line that you see right here comes across and plugs into the center of the primer bulb, the center output. And then the kill switches, the kill switch wiring harness, inside the saw is together like this. The shorter terminal goes right here, and then the longer one the longer wire goes right here. Let me turn this on over. You have two terminals there, two spay terminals here and here. So that's how that's going to come off of your saw. Again, part number, name, barcode. While we do come with a new switch with a new part, we have to change out the primer bulb, and we'll do that now. So I just pry it a little bit. The primer bulb pops loose. There's a this little, I want to call it a bonnet. You pull your hose through that. And put her hose back through the new bonnet. You'll notice the cutout in the bonnet fits the prongs in the line well. So, as always, this video will be uncut, unedited. If you're getting bored, you want to shut it off, shut it off. Otherwise, hang with me and we'll have this thing installed here in just a minute. Okay, we're going in like this. Primer bulb snaps in place. Nicely. The carb will go next. We'll go ahead and hook everything up here. Now we'll note that the O-rings are included and installed in the filter base. I'm going to assume that this rod is to be trapped inside of that linkage. The original that I have is popped loose. I don't know if I'm supposed to free that or not. Okay, I think that the switch works off of that spring, so mine was evidently broken. Alright, we're going to plug our fuel hose up here for the primer. Show these switches, or connections rather. So I've got three connectors on this particular setup. I don't know that it matters how you hook them up, but so the longest one I assume will go there. And these two are the same, they just have two different locations. There's that connector. Hook this one up. So if you're wondering about pay by the hour and hourly figures and whatnot, I had a guy come one morning, a friend of mine requested I work on this man's saw, and told me he had it tore down already, just needed me to put a piston on. Well, the saw was in such a configuration that I needed it separated completely down to the crankcases, and it wasn't. And he wound up being here 2 hours, and I don't want to say he was disappointed, but things didn't turn out. He thought he was just going to drop in, get his work done, and leave, but it doesn't work like that always. So now we've got to plug up to the computer, the stator, whatever you want to call it, and we're just going to plug this up. So I'm going to bring you in close and show you what's going on here. So we got a throttle cable. This line goes across to the primer bulb. That's our computer stator connector. And then we've got our fuel line itself that plugs right here. So this line will come across and plug in the back of the primer bulb. And so that's what we're going to be doing. You're going to be you won't be able to see what's going on, but having shown you that, you'll know that's what I'm doing. Throttle cable right here's our throttle cable end right there. Now down in under there is the fuel line. We'll have to get that next, and that is the supply line, be specific, right there. I'm going to hook up the stator wire or the computer wire, however you wish to call that. All right, computer wires together. It took a minute. All right. It's got to snap into the side of the car. There's that. That's done. Now for the kill switch, kill wire. I've had it on once. Pulled it off. Thank you. This is not easy. I'm going to bring these switches around the top, which may be incorrect. Or the wires, anyway. Okay, we're hooked up. All lined in rubber grommets. Things working. Have to plug up our primer hose. So I'm going to unplug that temporarily where I can see what I'm doing. Other fuel hose. Okay, everything is hooked up. I'm gonna say it went fairly easy. Okay, I got to put our bolts in. Give you a look see at it. Okay, I routed my keel wires over the top and then down through here instead of under the bottom the way it's originally set up, or the way this saw was. That may not be from the factory. Alright, hard bolts. All right, that's basically it. Everything's back together, hooked up. Throttle linkage, choke, kill switches, everything. Everything's supposed to be there. Of course, we got to reassemble this one. This is a complete teardown. Thank you for watching.